And so we've reached the halfway point of today's broadcast, folks. A little bit less than that, actually. But this will be our final match for China today. It concludes the first four games of the day. And after this, we'll have an hour or so break, I believe. And then we hop over to Europe. Lots of European Dota coming your way. But yeah, this is going to be LGD Gaming versus Tongfu. We'll quickly look at our groups here as soon as my computer decides to play ball. And we'll go over the standings. But for now, I'm on LD of Beyond the Summit, of course. And I have the pleasure to be joined here today, once again, by Blaze, who's been a trooper sticking through me with the marathon casting. Hey, Blaze.
Yeah, how's it going? I'm obviously looking forward to this game, and we've had some great games behind us. Hopefully some great games ahead today as well. I think we have five games in Europe today as well, so this is going to be another marathon ahead. And yeah, so far, been pretty epic. I mean, the Wisp Tiny coming out from FY Nisusice was an awesome way to just really get the blood flowing, and now we get to see here an interesting combo of heroes for the side of LGD and as well as for Tongfu. These two teams have been going kind of back and forth as far as who will take the wins. I think that Tongfu kind of had a rough morning, a couple losses, but they might be able to bounce back here. And you know, it's the best of one. Lots of things can happen. But it's interesting that we're going to actually see heroes like Tusk banned out, Ancient Air Person taken off the table. And they just obviously respect what those heroes are capable of, but it's one that I haven't personally seen picked up by LGD. So I'm curious what they had in mind. Is that something that you're familiar with MMY, I guess?
As far as what?
As far as the Tusk pickup, it's something that I haven't seen LGD run, but I know that MMY kind of carried that over a little bit when he switched.
I've seen a few Tuskar picks in the Chinese game. I can't really remember if MMY played it. If he did, it didn't leave a mark, I guess is sure. What I was... I'm pretty sure I did see him play one or two times, but it wasn't like, oh my god, this Tuskar's winning his team the game kind of thing, so...
Just you wait, man. This hero's OP, and his current status, it's just they haven't realized it yet. The pro players, they still need to take it to the next level there. They need to find their new level of counter-reactive play, Blink Dagger Tusk, breaking lassos, all this other random stuff. We'll see. But at least for now, we have a pretty solid lineup of just kind of death ball type heroes. The Viper's going to be on the front line for the most part. Doom's actually going to be in front of him, and then Viper will be doing what he can right behind. We see this matchup pretty frequently, the Viper, the Centaur, and it really comes down to the Stampede. It is a hero that doesn't die to double edge very easy. Viper, it's very tanky, has a lot of magic resistance, generally builds HP, so if Centaur's going to bring him down, he's going to need help, and that's a really key aspect of the hero. But still, if the Stampede's off, Viper actually makes Centaur look really slow. I mean, when you're seeing him running around at 522 movement speed, dropping him down to 200, that's going to be of pretty large impact. But for now, it's a hero to survive. They still need some good supports to bring utility, to bring four staffs against the Skywrath, and in general, just to allow them to actually bring some utility to the fights.
Brewmaster. Yeah, Brewmaster now picked up by LGD. So they get the combo we saw last game, the Centaur Brew, but it wasn't really a very effective combo as it turned out. But it's a very different type of draft from Tongfu. We're not seeing the Tiny Wisp. We're not seeing that great spread the map lineup. More of a clashing lineup. And, well, if you want to clash, then, hey, Centaur and Brewmaster, you'd rather... I don't think there's two bruisers you'd rather bring to a fight than them. Maybe a Faceless Void, though. He has been just kind of ignored the past week or so, interestingly enough.
Yeah, at least on the Chinese scene, it's been a kind of variance. We saw, obviously, Chuan pick it up and have limited success with that. And in general, it's a hero that has been toned down a little bit. We still see, I think the North American scene still runs it a ton, but there's a lot of ways to deal with it in different respects. You can get ultis that work well in the Chronosphere so that you can punish any time that the Void accidentally chronos his own allies. You can use that as a time frame where you can pop a Yule Scepter on the Void, Ethereal Blade his target. Plenty of different ways to respond. So we see more reactive picks. We see heroes that can work around it. And it shifts the metagame to something new. So Bristleback is going to come out for Tongfu here. A very fun pickup. And has a lot of potential with the sustain of the Witch Doctor. You give the Witch Doctor Voodoo Restoration to the Bristleback, he starts going YOLO. Even underneath towers, he's going to be able to make a large impact. And the cool thing about Bristle is that he's not necessarily entirely reliant on right clicks. You ensnare him, you Drunken Haze him. It's still not going to mean that he isn't doing any damage because the Bristleback passive, as well as his close sprays, just tear people apart.
Honestly, I looked at this pick and I'm like, you know what? They should really pick Ancient Apparition. He would be amazing against Tongfu, but he's banned. So, yeah. Would have been a fantastic pick. They have very heal centric lineup. Three heroes that normally build a lot of HP regen. There's Scorched Earth. There's the pipe that this team will probably build. The mech. But doesn't matter. Can't use it. They'll go for the lion instead, though, an MMY signature hero. This guy just has a knack for playing Lion and actually winning the laning stage. Like, I've seen a lot of other great Lion players who have their impact later on, but very few have consistently set up kills early on, as MMY has. But it's a new team, and we'll have to see if the streak will continue without Lanham at his side, as LGD has just been, for me, very hit or miss with their new roster. Like, if I would look at the Chinese teams right now, I would say IG's been completely hot and cold, like extremely hot and cold. LGD's kind of been more in the middle, but they've had some really great games, some decent ones. And I look at VG Gaming as the team who's been sloppy but consistently impressive. Like, the last game was not the smoothest Tiny Wisp I've ever seen. Still more than good enough. And Newbie is the team to me that kind of looks lost right now in China. But yeah, LGD, so many talented players. It's just they're all new to playing with each other, honestly. Outside of, I guess, Sylar and Yao, who have some history together.
Yeah, but yeah, definitely.
Yeah, it does seem like they're still finding their footing. I still think this LGD team will be top two in China once they, if they ever manage to get their stuff together. Just in terms of raw talent and overall potential as a team, I rank them as top two. But, with that said, for now, they struggle. So they may make me look silly here if they get crushed by Tongfu.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it would be an unfortunate loss, but they'll give their best shot. I think they have a lot of potential here with this draft. I mean, MMY Lion is just, I mean, if you can put a hero to a player, he just loves that, and he's going to be able to do a lot of work with it in the early game. Just kind of going for a kind of bare bones build, just a little bit of consumables here and there, but he'll be active enough just with a good attack animation of the hero, decent base damage, and being able to get some large disables, especially with the early hex. So looking forward to that. But it's going to be Sylar and Nagasiren that I think is going to be the standout for LGD. If they can breach into the mid to late game, there's so much potential with Sylar on this hero in particular. And he's going to be pulled up a lot of tangos, gets 6 in total. So he still not only will find bottle regen, but be able to maybe survive harassment from the Viper, which isn't something you often get to say.
And with that, we'll go ahead and introduce the teams. Tongfu, they're 0-3, LGD 1-2 so far in Star Ladder, and we'll run through the lineups. Red will be playing your offlane Clockwork. It's U9 on the solo mid Viper, LPC as the Jungle Doom. I wonder if there's any chance he has the same impact of the Jungle Doom we saw earlier. Xiaolu on the Bristleback safe lane, Kabu the Witch Doctor. And that will conclude the introductions for Tongfu. Over on the side of LGD, we've got Angelai as the offlane Centaur. Faith will be playing your support, Skywrath Mage for him. Sylar, as you mentioned, going mid on the Naga. This puts MMY under the Lion and Yao under the Brew. And right as this Dire Observer Ward gets plopped down, it was spotted out by a previously placed Radiant One. So I wonder if they're going to give Red a Sentry just to allow him to deward. But the Sentries are currently not picked up. Did anyone on Tongfu save for those? Hmm. Nobody saved for Sentries.
Yeah, that's really interesting. Generally speaking, you're going to have at least a pair to start off with, but we do see that... They split them up so I could, on the side of LGD, but Tongfu here, they're going for a little bit more activity in the early stages. Obviously, they've got the greed pick already with the Jungle Doom, so I guess it's just going to be something they have to wait for, and maybe they'll be pulling him up later on, but... For now, it's just going to be the Cogblock back for Red on the offlane. He's going to be able to control the Creepilibrium pretty well. Like, MMY, even with the pull unlock, will still take about a good minute
bottom
or
lane,
two to get it back. Bottom
lane, Kabu's in trouble now. They've wrapped around on him. They baited him out a bit with Faith. Oh, can't quite kill him off, but that was a lot of damage. If they got a range for a stomp, which they were very close, it would have been first blood, but sorry about that. Go ahead.
It's really too much to go over here. Starting off with the Doom, like going in the jungle here, he's going to go for the Dark Troll Summoner Devour, so that will give him some nice neutrals to tank up. And that's important because right now he only has tangos to HP regen, he only has zero armor and no stout shield. So he needs these frontline tanks to actually stay up. The only other way the jungle could be pulled off with this kind of an item set would be with a Wild Wing Ripper and going for the tornado play with stacks. So it's good for him to at least find one of the two, and although we don't see any Wild Wings to speak of, he's just going to be able to use the summons to great effect with that clarity.
Yeah, and even if you find a Wild Wing, you need the Monopole to support the tornado. So you'd at least have to hit level 3 to get that off, or maybe buy a branch, I suppose, is the other option. But yeah, this bottom lane for Kabu, he was just getting a pounding by Faith. He's forced to use pretty much all his mana on the heal. Bring Xiaolu to full, but they're pushing in the bottom lane. They're giving a lot of experience to the LGD dual lane, and they're not pulling it back, though Kabu will move to potentially stack and pull this one. He'll get there, it looks like, just in the nick of time, as LPC will wait to check the bottom rune. Meanwhile, a skirmish at the top rune. There's Battery Assault level 1. Sylar does not have a point of mirror image, but he's reserved to skill points here, so... Oh, gets pushed away by the cogs. crafty play from Red as he snags the invis and, more importantly, denies it to Sylar. Meanwhile, Dire Ancient's being stacked up by Faith.
Yep. Nice way to get some early income for the team in general. They don't have great Ancient Clear in general, but, I mean, just being able to do it with two or three heroes at a time can really enhance their income. Red, though, he's actually going to stick around here in the mid lane. There is some potential that Sylar here. If he gets caught in the cogs and the battery stall, this actually could be the first blood.
Well, in the middle of the creep wave, though, Sylar can mirror image. So he'll mirror image, but it's the wrong... he doesn't come out in the end. He's stuck inside the cogs as Unai chases him down. This might well be the first blood. Battery assault? Didn't use it. I guess doesn't need it in the end.
Wow. I mean, there was one creep there and then multiple mirror images later on, so I guess it probably would have done about as much damage as an auto attack anyways for the cast animation. But yeah, it's just awesome that they're able to get the cogs in, and that's enough for them to bring it down. Now, cask bouncing just once, but still going to get a lot of damage to this guy.
No, only level 3 in Shaloo. He's just going to stack up the quills. But that base 325 move speed, too strong. Still diving. He actually took an early point in level death, LPC. He thought he could get the kill. That's kind of costly to the Doom. It's going to hurt his economy a bit.
His jungle is going to be extremely slow now. Like, he's going to be going for a tranquil boot buildup. He's only got 1 point in Scorched Earth and 1 point in Devour. Yeah, and he's running the Kobold Taskmaster speed order. Right? So
it almost helped him get that kill, but not quite. Yeah.
Lion caught inside the cogs up here. Battery's not doing work, but the Brewmaster's going to be able to come and save the day, get some really good damage on Red in return. So MMY's got plenty of tangos to heal himself back up, and it's back to the offlane status for you, Red. But all the same, yeah, this Doom really wanted to gank. He obviously, like, he went for the Orb of Venom speed aura and the level death. This is entirely a gank-oriented build. He's trying to kind of duplicate what Kaka accomplished earlier this morning, and it's just not going to happen with this kind of HP pool. Like, he's got to really go back to the fountain, shift his timing, and really look to gank when he can get the level death on a level 6 multiplier.
Yeah, obviously, not only is his jungling slowed down, but this means that he's not going to have a quick Midas either, as he's not finding the kill gold, and just getting his level 6 will be a bit of a problem here for LPC. And when he gets it, everyone in LGD will be a bit tankier than what they normally would be. As LGD in July will make a move down. They have an Observer Ward here. They've spotted out the Witch Doctor, but Kabu, oh, does he cask in time? No, he's slowed down. They don't want to chase that far. Yeah. And Shaolu will force them back in the end.
It is only a level 2 Skywrath Mage, so it doesn't have the Silence, and it's not really able to put out that much pressure when there's always going to be damage in return. He's very low armor against the Bristleback, so the fight lasts more than like 7 or 8 seconds, and he's automatically dead. But I think that right now, Doom's best route is going to be ganking any level 6 hero on the map. Right now, it's going to be the Naga Siren very soon, and the level death does a huge amount of damage when you get that extra boost. But yeah, he's got the mana and the Tranquil Boot regen. He should be able to find an opening. It's going to be a kind of long, exaggerated flank to gank, but eventually he'll get in position where they could actually get a kill on the Naga once more.
Yeah, it could be a kill. And, well, the question is if Sylar is going to take that point in ult. If he does and they don't burst him, then he might be able to stall and run away. Though, let's see, Bottle coming back in, and he's still got a couple of tangos in his inventory, so this will be a tough kill. If they go in right now and he doesn't song, maybe they could do it. Let's see if he skills it up. I have seen Sylar skip it at level 6. He's been greedy before, but I'm thinking mid lane he's more likely to take it. Still holding a skill. He's just going to hold the skill point. Well, that works too.
Yeah. Doom can't find the opening. There's going to be two roaming in to try to help him out. And yeah, it's actually a 4v2 flank to gank from in July as well. But obviously they have this Radiant Observer Ward. They see at least the Centaur's movement and they can apply the rest.
And so in July, we'll trot back towards bottom lane. Meanwhile, I think for me, the MVP so far, this game has been Red. He's done oh, hold that thought. U9's gotten caught out in the river. Level 7, but surrounded by 3 heroes of LGD. He went to check that top rune and unfortunately with no vision, paid. But Red will rotate in now. He picks up the invis, goes directly into Faith. He's got level 3 battery salt. He's so close to getting in range, but I think Faith might have saw him at the last second and will end up retreating out. But yeah, this clock has still done a lot of work. Got the first kill for the team, and on top of that, he's really done a nice job of zoning out and just slowing down MMY's level progression.
Mm-hmm. And controlling runes in general. Like, he's picked up so many that could have refreshed Sylar, so he's occupying the courier quite frequently. And just in general, I kind of feel like just getting some damage in July. They won't be able to bring him down. But, Viscous Nezuku is up on the Bristleback. Yeah, they're going to corner him. Pincer formation, but
4 heroes.
In July, not in range, and there's the Stampede.
Well, Viper strike him one more. Auto attack might be enough to take him down to the poison. He sticks up, and they still chase. LPC getting stunned. Sylar has a song ready. If they need to disengage, they can. But they're going in for the kill on the Doom, and they'll secure it.
Yeah.
Overextension. So, well, the Doom's economy already off to a bad start. He even leveled up Scorched Earth. So not only did he take the early point in level death, but now he's even more committed to these early ganks, and it continues to be an unsuccessful start for him.
Yeah, I kind of feel like the what you're talking about before with Red's movement and his really great impact on the early game as an offlane clockwork that you usually don't see only serves as a counteraction tool to how poorly the Doom's jungling experience has gone. Like, this has been a build-up that really intends to make an impact on the game and hasn't done even remotely that. He's actually going to be right-clicking down the center instead of devouring it, too. So, yeah, I don't really just find LPC's routes to be efficient. I don't find him finding the openings that he needs. And although it creates space for the solo heroes, like, why do you do that? I mean,
just wait for devour to cool down.
Oh, you get the gold slightly sooner because his HP is missing, but whatever. I don't know.
Well, it's a level 1 devour, so it really doesn't, yeah, I mean, it's going to cool down anyway by the time that you're ready to go. Mm-hmm. You'll have finished devouring him. MMY on the retreat out, and, oh, he's in a bad position here. This lion's going back to the well. They'll at least get the kill there, but, yeah, LPC has, he's really hamstrung his team with these failed early movements, and, well, it's now going into a bracer, so completely focused on ganking. And not a lineup that scales hugely well into the late game for Tong Fu. So I'm feeling like this next 10 minutes, Blaze, this is their time to make a mark.
Well, it's all on Red then, because he's the one who can really bring the initiation despite things like Song of the Siren and Stampede. Getting the cogs on somebody can really turn things around, but Yao's already got that Blink Dagger and a TP scroll, so if they ever make a overextension, just too aggressive of a movement, he's going to be there to respond. So it's got to be Red to start it, and they probably also need the Bristleback as well as the Witch Doctor to follow through, because if you don't have those three pieces in play, the Brewmaster's just going to turn it around 9 times out of 10.
Xiaolu now has a Vitality Booster delivered, so a fantastic item to keep aggressive at this stage of the game. And I'm just waiting to see when Tong Fu look to strike. It's kind of the combi for the Storm. The clock does move bottom, but this was spotted out by a Dire Observer Ward. So even if Red goes in, chances are pretty good that LGD will be ready to respond. And in fact, they're already making that play. Smoking up, heading down bottom lane. MMY, no level 6. But if he gets a kill or two in this fight, he might have it in time, and they're going right onto the Doom. He has Scorched Earth. Will he pop it in time? Oh, no. Silence. Impale Clap. Down he goes.
He got Scorched Earth, though. This is having a rough game. Like, this is the one of those that you don't personally come back from. Like, your team could still carry you on their shoulders, but as far as his personal experience, he is just going to be a walking ultimate. Like, he can't actually do much more for the next, like, 20 minutes or so. It's so far gone. I mean, like I said, the level death is still an ability that scales really well depending on your enemy's level, so that could still be pretty valuable, as we do see that the Lion's going to be hitting level 6 pretty soon, and Skyrath will eventually have to get there, but at least for right now, there's just really little that he can do.
Yeah, and meanwhile, Sylar, after that first blood, is still farming exceptionally well. He's your leader in terms of net worth, and he's got all the pieces that precede the Radiance. At this point, I don't think we'll see Sylar build anything else. He could go Drums, could go Defusal, but his team has a great space-creating backbone, and they'll now go in with the Stampede straight onto U9. The silence is there.
Oh, the mech.
Follow-up from the Double Edge.
He didn't have enough. He was 25 gold off.
I think he still goes down there anyway, but maybe they get a kill or two.
I mean, like, he didn't get to buy it. He loses the gold. It just
delays it. Oh, he didn't get to buy it. Okay. Hookshot in from Red, but not to no avail.
Painful. I mean, that is a level 1 Song, so it is going to be a pretty long cooldown there, but, I mean, disengaging cleanly, delaying the mechanism of the Viper, and getting more time for Sylar to just do his thing. It's Tong Fu really have to change it. And unfortunately, with the hookshot on cooldown, they have 50 seconds to wait out before they do so. Up top, we do see Doom playing shenanigans with the Brewmaster, but can't really hold his own there for long.
Wow. Like you said, rough game. I mean, it's still a useful hero because he's Doom. So You could just still delete the Brewmaster from the team fights if you get a jump on him. But even managing to farm a Blink Dagger is going to be quite an ordeal for him. Meanwhile, Red is waiting for the hookshot to cool down and still looking for an opening. They will have the mech very soon, despite the death for U9. They'll have it in, like, 30 seconds or so. And LPC wants to go in top lane. Well, no, maybe not. He's too low to do it. He's, like, constantly too low to fight is really the problem as well. Never dropping his Tranquil Boots when he's killing off camps, and they're constantly disabled when he needs to be healing. But he'll now move towards mid, and they'll get another very strong item for this stage of the game in the Vanguard for Xiaolu, but not something that's going to scale well later on. So again, more and more pressure being piled up on Tong Fu's next 10 minutes.
It's insanely good against a Brewmaster, though. The Primal Split Pandas don't do hardly any damage except for the fire ones, so you're going to be blocking all their damage with a 40 block. A lot of people don't know the Earth and Wind Pandas both do piercing damage. That's 75% against heroes pre-mitigation, and then 40 damage off that is just going to be nothing at all. So only has to worry about the Fire Panda damage, and the other right clicks are minimal. The mirror images, etc. Yep. And the block is actually going to be really valuable for a long period of time.
No song here to go in. I'm here. Oh, jump in. In July, stomp on Unine. The silence from the Scarlet Mage will follow this up. Clockwork has hooked himself in, but it's only on Yao, who manages to get off his split anyway, in spite of that, the Witch Doctor being channeled from low ground to high ground, though, and it looks like the turn comes as a result. Great counter initiation. Too much beef in the front lines for Tong Fu, and now they'll look to run down this Brewmaster. Can he blink himself away? That's the question. The Earth Panda surrounded a bit. He cyclones up one, then the Clockwork cogs them all away. Well, they weren't getting him anyway, I feel, but in the end, it'll help ensure his escape. But this is a hero that we've seen the Chinese teams love to run as a counter to Brew. This Bristleback, just so effective at killing off the Fire Panda, tanking the damage, and turning these early game fights.
Yeah, and they use the mech, the Voodoo Restoration rank 2 perfectly, and they can just continue to sustain. They might even look at Roche. It's generally something that's off the table for a Radiant team, but there's no way of killing them if the Witch Doctor has mana. Right now, he's got 10 Magic Stick charges, Arcanes, and 30. He's actually feeling pretty good about himself. For now, they make their way down bottom, but MMY, RATPing away, it's going to be the tier 1 push for them.
Still, as I feel I say so often whenever I cast his games, Sylar is for me. I wouldn't be resting on my laurels if I was Tong Fu. If I were Tong Fu, I should say.
And do you think pipes in the cards for any of Tong Fu's heroes?
Maybe for Bristleback. I don't think Doom's gonna farm it.
No.
Clockwork probably will get like a Blade Mail or a Force Staff, or maybe even an Eggs. And I don't like the idea of stacking pipe and mech on the same hero. Just makes them too easy to ruin the fight for your team if they get jumped.
Sure.
And LGD have the heroes to do it with a Lion, Stampede, and even the Salt of the Siren, quite nice.
Yeah. So I'm curious if the Clockwork wants to opt for the Blade Mail buildup or the pipe. He's actually going to miss the hookshot. Kind of no pretty hero in that specific direction.
Like, he had already moved a few. I feel like he targeted the hookshot before.
Like, he shift queued it from his TP in.
Yeah, like, Red shot. Like, Centaur was here. He moved all the way over there, and then the hookshot came. It wasn't like an inch off, it was like a second and a half off.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Might find him still. I don't know. There's the TP.
Well, we're ragging on Tong Fu, but hey, they're still leading by 3k gold. As you would expect for this draft, they should be up early. But if they can just keep this pressure up, maybe they can take enough of a lead to force the LGD high ground. Still LGD making smart trades overall. Three heroes pushing in the bottom lane. One in Sylar farming the mid. He's now up to 2800 gold. We're probably looking at like a 20-21 minute Radiance if he keeps up this level of farm. And if he gets some kills, it could be even sooner. With the tower going down mid, that will boost it by a bit, now up to 3,300. All of a sudden, 500 gold in his pockets. So yeah, maybe even a bit sooner, maybe even 19 minutes in or so he could have.
Yeah, and that's the timer for Tong Fu. They should be at least taking down a tier 3 by that time frame. They've got 5 minutes to do it, they've got a great death ball lineup, but they really can't just kind of rest, sit on their laurels or anything. If they get a couple kills on the Naga to push her back, great. But otherwise, they should just be focusing on the offensive, keeping one person to defend the towers while the Rockethar counter pushes, and otherwise keep the forward momentum rolling.
LGD are waiting. They're going to jump in on Xiaolu, but he's quite tanky. Not tanky enough. Oh, who am I kidding? Hookshot in from Red. We'll find Fate. This will be the death of the Scarlet Mage, and then they'll doom up Sylar. That's the big kill, delaying his relic. He does have the gold for it, but he's going to end up going down to the Ancients here. He bought the recipe for it instead, but did not manage to purchase the relic itself. Red now on the chase as the rest of LGD retreat out. I think he bought the recipe.
He did buy the recipe.
Yeah,
there's no value in that because he's still rocking like a 1,200 unreliable gold. So it does not take away. It doesn't make it so that.
Yeah, he still loses gold when he dies. Available. Yeah. Yeah, that was just a panic. Oh shit, I'm gonna die. He did get denied to the neutrals at least, but they'll get LPC as the trade here. Poor guy. It's been a rough game for him.
Yeah, and if you're going to have a hero that has an extremely difficult game and is almost useless as far as just what his items go with, it might as well be Doom. I mean, you're still going to be contributing more than almost any other hero in the game just based on your ultimate alone. So we'll see if he can build up anything relevant. Looks like a BKB's in the cards for him, and that'll at least allow him to just kind of stand his ground with the Scorched Earth and the BKB.
Bottom lane, the jump is ready. They're going to prep to go on U9 and the clappy for the blink. Yeah.
Just Dodo before Blink Dodo.
wasn't disabled either. Just a mispress, I guess. Not sure what his hotkey setup is, but yeah, whatever it was not the right button to press there. That was a free kill too on the Viper. They didn't have that. They had one hero backing him up at the time, and now they've got five. It's a bit of a missed opportunity.
Yeah, so the bottom tier one's going to go down, but I think they should honestly go for the tier two. Like, their waves in mid and top are okay enough that if they just rocket flare, they can keep pushing on the bottom lane, take two towers, and make Roche a real possibility, which I think is still necessary for them to go up against all these ulties for the high ground.
At the very least, they should take this tier one, and maybe they back to defend the tier two. It's not going to die, but it will take significant damage with three LGD heroes pounding away at it. But they're just going to keep on pushing. They'll leave three here. One a bit farther back in LPC, and he'll grab a teleport scroll. And LGD, content to force out that one TP, will immediately retreat out.
Yeah, this is what they need to do. Just have Clockwork on the back lines, his Rocket Flare, he can hold the line, and they can force this issue on this bottom tower. They're going to try to counter-engage, but it's too late. They can't rally their troops fast enough, and they don't feel comfortable in that engagement. So, like I said, that's what they need to do, is just get that to claim general map control and make it more difficult for LGD to get active across the map. They don't have anything in a global sense other than the Stampede, and taking down these towers is going to really hurt them as far as getting to the fight when they need to, and Tongfu can just start singling people out.
Radiance is about to come out now for Sylar. He's got 3,500 gold, and unlike most games, he's already got the recipe, so... It will, even with the death there, denied to the neutrals, it'll still be like a 19-20 minute Radiance. And
pretty insane.
It goes back to the fact that they did manage to grab a couple towers. Had Tongfu had a better early start and held on to their outer towers, then maybe this wouldn't be the case. But that's like an extra 1,000 gold into his pockets. And as soon as that Radiance comes out, the question is, can Tongfu do anything to stop the rat? They have Clockwork, they have Doom. On paper, these are two of the better heroes to deal with it, but... The Doom is so poor. He's got no Blink Dagger, no real mobility, so it's really just on Clock, and I'm not convinced Clock alone is enough.
Yeah, and the item buildups seem a little bit out of sync here. They're looking for a range of initiation. They're looking to engage and just find somebody at long range. With the, of course, they've drafted the Clockwork for this, but they're actually going to pick up Sanjin Yasha on the Bristleback and a Blink Dagger on the Witch Doctor. They really want to be in all pursuit mode. Find an opening, take it off. But we also see the Viper and the Doom are building up kind of stand and deliver type things. They're not quick, they're just there. And they can take through a lot of damage, but they won't be able to join those pickoffs, and it's going to be more often a 3-versus-1 play than anything else.
Still waiting for that hook in mid. Very patient siege from Tongfu. And Sylar has finally completed his Radiance, and this will slow down the push. Tongfu, you asked about a pipe. We're not seeing one. Uh-uh. The mech is out, but slowly these supports will burn down. Witch Doctor is probably one of the best supports in the game to counter this Radiance burn, yet they still are letting the creep wave dive, and bottom lane is pushing in. So LGD just bide their time, and they look for Tongfu to back off. We'll probably see an image sent around from behind this time to cut the wave. Just one in at first. Sylar keeping the rest back. No, Blink and stop. They're going to go now. Whoa. Straight onto Xianlu. Here's your initiation from LGD. MMY combines. They instantly give down the Bristleback. Then the Brewmaster split comes out. LPC dropping the Doom, but very ineffectively as LGD chase forward. Stomped. They'll kill off LPC too. Kabu tries to fight this one, but he's got nothing. No Witch Doctor ult. No way out. Cyclone up in the air. The Brew split still working against Doom 9. Now it ends. A clap. A few more auto attacks, and Sylar will collect a kill or two. Yeah, he's getting a lot of assist gold for this one. It's four dead. It's going to be a full wipe. There's no way out of this. Kabu on the retreat, but no chance.
They used the hook, the cogs, and the doom on a Naga illusion. They called, they pinged the wrong one. Sylar stays in the back, and the illusion takes two ultis. And suddenly, there's no team fight for Tongfu. They got the great initiation on Bristleback, who's just, he's not heart level tanky. He's tanky, but not 1v4 level, and... Yeah, they just wasted way too much on Sylar's fake.
Yeah, that was not a very good fight for Tongfu. Also, Xiaolu just died instantly. Like, this Bristleback needs a BKB. He just got assassinated by the Skyrath Mage. That plus Finger of Death, he died within 2 seconds. And he's their biggest damage, sustained damage dealer outside the Viper, who stayed alive, but can be controlled nicely by the Brewmaster. So, with the wasted Doom and... Also, just the instant death of Xiaolu. It was a pretty unwinnable fight for Tongfu. And now Sylar. BOT is nearly completed. He's got another 500 gold to go for those. Now your leader in terms of net worth. And he's getting to that point where Tongfu just can't let him farm anymore. They got to keep on pushing in.
Mm-hmm. With the Primal Split on cooldown, they're going to try to force at least the tier 2 here. But after that, they don't have really anywhere to go. If they try to fight against the Primal Split, the only way that I see them actually taking that fight is if they get a Blink into the trees from Kabu and he gets a Death Ward out of their line of sight. Because pretty much all of their abilities to prevent him from casting do require line of sight. I think Impale is the only one, or Earthspike rather, is the only one that will disable it without vision. I guess you could stomp, but that's weird. So, yeah.
Hookshot in. And jump on in July, but he's going to force death himself out of the cogs. Something Tong Fu don't really have an answer for, and that will end the attempt. A good
pickup
versus the
right now. They feel the pressure of what that Silas is putting on them just by being there, just by farming, and just by building up. They know they have to do something, but they're not sure what, so it really just seems like they're flailing their arms about and not really finding what they're looking for.
And he's got BOTs now. So Tong Fu really up against it as the split push will ramp up by several orders. LGD moving through their jungle now and just biding their time while the Sylar effect kicks in. Well, let me tell you, the Sylar effect is not fun for the opposition. It's kicking in quickly, too.
Mm-hmm.
Already up to another 800 gold to go with the completed BOTs. That's 1,300 gold he's farmed in like a minute and a half at most. Probably even less than that. It's only going to get worse from here.
Yeah, I really liked originally like seeing how tanky Tong Fu were getting with the buildup of the mech. They kind of, that big fight that they turned around, you could see these guys have a lot of durability to bring to the table. The problem is they're just up against so much damage. The Figure of Death, the Double Edge, the Mystic Flare, like these heroes are designed to just blow you to pieces no matter how big you can get. And it just doesn't seem like any level of HP is enough for them. And a Tong Fu, they're desperate. They're going to go in, they're going to get the hook.
Battery solid. But the turn comes from MOY. Perhaps not. Sylar, he's caught out in the cogs, but he's four-stepped out. And now Songs, and I'll TP out. All of that for a dead clockwork. How frustrating.
Mm-hmm.
LGD doing a nice job of protecting him.
Yeah, the only way they cancel a Song TP if he's not already doomed up is going to be the hookshot. And obviously, Clockwork is using that for the most part just to initiate. They could technically like blink cask initiate and then follow up with hookshot that way. But otherwise, there's just no way for them to close distance on this hero. Already very naturally fast, naturally playing defensive, and it's just so damn hard. We see the Stampede is going to be back up in 30 seconds. And even if the Song isn't, they're still going to have one more get out of jail free card.
It's almost where they need, like, that Orchid Clockwork of Bone 7, but he just doesn't have the farm to support it. As MMY blinks in, he'll drop an Observer Ward here in the Radiant Jungle, and Yao and Injuli start to group up together. Double-edging the creeps, Injuli will now rotate down bottom, and you can see the infestation spreads. One illusion killing off the one creep camp that's annoying for a Naga, which is those golems, but another creep camp being killed off here. Creeps even being pulled by illusions towards the medium camp or the small camp, and yeah, Sylar's continuing to farm. He's got the gold for Yasha, and not too far off from the Manta, at which point, the only real solution for him is Doom.
Yeah, exactly, and it's obviously, they're not really confident about dooming Naga Sirid right now because of just the illusion fiasco that happened in the mid lane there. They know that anyone could just be imitating and won't really actually get them any real value as a single target, but yeah, the virus, it's spreading. Sylar moving in towards that Manta, and I don't know if they have a great comeback tool once he gets it. Like, obviously, there's still possibilities that Sylar just get picked off a couple of times in a row, but like, even as you mentioned, like the Bone 7 buildup, Orchid versus Manta wouldn't do anything. Sylar's just too big. He's got this gigantic net worth advantage, and although you would love to see this Bristle Pack be able to do some work against it, he's their focus. He's able to go down quickly enough, and LGD, they have their number.
Yeah, they had a pretty mediocre start, but it doesn't really matter at this point. This is like ultimately, at this stage of the game, this is about where you want to be with the Naga, even in terms of gold and having her core items out. And they're just going to play 4 Protect 1. They'll smoke up, they keep on hesitating, first heading north, then down south, and then back north again. And in the end, they'll make their way up the ramp. Now wrapping around, looking to backstab U9, and it seems they'll be successful. Blink in, impale to start this Hex to follow up. Mystic Flare, easy kill. The MMY Blink works its magic again. And they can just rinse and repeat every time Stampede's ready.
Exactly. As long as Song is available, they're happy to use Stampede offensively. If it's unavailable, they'll keep it for the defense. But no matter the case, they are finding openings, and anytime they pick off one, they disable the potential for any 5-man movement. In fact, they could consider Roshan now, as they do have both the Song and the Split, and they are, of course, on the dire side. Now, as far as the farming game goes, passivity is probably better than forcing an issue in the big pit, but it's still an option on the table here, as we do see Naga building up hard. 4,000 gold banked up. Siler, it was already impressive to get the ratings at that time, but now the way he's using it to farm is just dramatically increasing him until, like, there's no other hope. Like, he's going to be so far gone in a matter of minutes that if Tongfu don't do something now, they're going to be crushed.
Even this Doom is still struggling against the Radiance Bird, and generally Doom's a pretty tanky hero, can withstand the damage a bit better, but until he popped Scorched Earth, he was dropping extremely low, and Tongfu just, they don't have their momentum anymore. They wanted a fast-paced game, an action-based game, and a game where they were constantly fighting the towers and finding kills and threatening this LGD base, but they haven't even been on the dire side of the map in a long time. They'll go for it now, but it's with a smoke gank. It's not with creep support. Even if they get a kill here, unless it's the Naga, they're unlikely to take an objective, and that Naga is just lurking mid. They might actually run into Sylar. They're wrapping around almost directly on top of Metal Song, just to the nick of time. That was close, though.
Heartbreaking. Like, they need something.
Almost to hook him! Hook! But, can't get enraged for battery, so. Almost timed it perfectly. Had to hook right as the song wore off. Or if Sylar had cancelled it early for some reason, maybe could have gotten in there, but wasn't the case.
Rubens just going for a Morbid Mask. I guess they can go for the Vladimir's Offering. Will help out all the melee pieces. The Brewling's obviously getting bonus damage there, too. With this Aghanim Scepter and the Vladimir's Offering, he himself is just like a 1v3 Wrecking Crew. He can do so much work, and as far as Silence, they only have the Doom, which we've mentioned needs to go on the Naga if they're going to have any hope in the fights. So it's so difficult to be in this position, this far behind, and only having the one Doom available, and knowing that as the minutes tick by, your win rate percentage chance drops into the single digits here.
Yeah, Silark did end up going back for a completed Mantis style, so not rushing the heart, but that'll be his next pickup. And by the time he gets that, even if they doom him, I'm not convinced they kill him. And that's assuming you get the right one, which has already been a problem in and of itself for them once. But that's the sad thing, is I don't think we've seen LPC. It's not even that he missed Doomed that fight. It's like they haven't gotten to use Doom since then. It's been like 12 minutes.
Yeah. Doom on cooldown is a Doom miss, I suppose. We're going to see this initiation on him, and it's another fight without him. Oh, he does have buyback, though.
Witch Doctor in a great position for this ultimate, though. It's bouncing here, there, and everywhere. Kills off one. It still continues to work on illusions, but the real chase is on the other end of the engagement, where Sylar TP's out, barely escaping with his life. He wasn't level 16 yet, so the ult wasn't ready. But it will be the level 3 ult soon, and that's going to make these sorts of fights much more difficult to find. Only a minute at most to make something happen if the song's used.
Yeah. Doom not even getting the chance to use his 10-second BKB, not willing to use the buyback, just
and,
taking him
and
out
not
fight.
Getting to use Doom.
Yeah.
Literally not getting to play as hero.
Yeah, that's about right, as far as this game goes. I mean, I kind of think there was a big turning point in the mentality shift in general, and where Tongfu had an opportunity to really press their advantage and press this early game lineup was that Doom flank around the Naga Siren hitting 6. If the support hadn't been coming in, and Doom had felt confidence going in and just getting that big nuke, the level death on Siler. Let's say he didn't fall back at Bottle Crow, and let's say that he was still sitting at like 2/3 HP. I mean, it's a lot of what ifs, but you bring that there, you get that kill, you start shutting him down there, and the Doom starts pulling ahead because he was level 4 at the time, ganking a level 6 hero, and that would just put him right back in the game. But his forced passivity from the LGD response, and suddenly Tongfu are on the back end of this for the rest of the game.
Yeah, the only way that's going to change is if somehow they manage to take Siler out of the game for a long time, which will require a death, a buyback, and then hope bottom
no BKB again.
Jump in on the LPC. They got off the Hex, the Impale, and down he goes. It's a BKB that he's yet to use. Meanwhile, top lane, just casual TP out. Nothing Tongfu can really do to prevent that one. It's one of those games where, like, their base hasn't even been threatened yet, but you just feel the absolute crushing sense of complete hopelessness.
Yeah. I mean, they've got 3 10-second BKBs. They should be in fighting form right now, but you just don't see anything. At best, they take a fight that LGD half loses and then disengages, and then they turtle, and they keep the waves pushed out, and there is no win condition for Tongfu. They need something huge. I mean, the Aghanim's BKB Witch Doctor would be great, but right now he's just looking for level 11, and the LGD's in the pit.
Yeah, at this point, I'm pretty sure they have to win, like, 3 fights in a row, and, like, fairly convincing fights, too. At least fights where they kill the Naga. And Sylar is, well, getting to that, not completely unkillable. You can never say never with Doom, but he's getting close to that point where if he gets a heart and they Doom him, they need to, like, actually have two or three other heroes there to kill him. Otherwise, he'll just run away, wait it out, support will arrive. And the other thing to consider is even if they go on him, there's always Centaur who... It's kind of the Doom counter. If he's not the one that you're focusing, he could just stampede and very likely be able to help the Naga escape, barring a Cogs.
And that's assuming they can even see it. We're going to actually see them move towards the pit, but although it was a very slow one, it does fall before they have a chance to engage. And as far as seeing them, you look at this illusion from Sylar spreading across the jungle. They've got Geometry Sight on them. So the second they walk up to the only ward that's on the map, I guess they just now place the second one, but even still... Siler's just going to be able to keep his jungle safe, and if they can see him, then he knows it, and he can see that fact. So they get a Geometry Sight on the side of the Witch Doctor, on the side of Tongfu. They're going to try to get back control of the map in general, but it's just they're not going to get any intel into what Siler's doing, and he's perfectly fine with staying on his side of the map for the rest of the game if necessary.
Yeah, Angelai's got a great Observer Ward here. Just spotted 3-4 heroes in the Radiant Jungle, and so he pushed this lane in all the way. He was just sitting here... at about a third HP, stomp double edging, and fears nothing. And LPC will back off and just try and cure the plague, but this virus keeps on evolving. There's new strains every hour, every minute, really, it feels.
Not as bad as the PL, which self-propagates, but even still,
I don't know, man. I preferred PL to Naga. Naga's a dirty, dirty hero.
Yeah, the disengage is, I think, the most brutal part. Like... you have to draft one of three different heroes to cancel that Song TP, or there's no way you stop her. You hex her, you silence her, you doom her. Otherwise, she's just perfectly fine. And the doom hasn't gotten the Blink Dagger until relatively recently. So LPC just not finding the openings. He's the one they need to make the plays. And to this game, unfortunately, he does seem like the weak link. So right now, Tongfu, they're trying to rally together, but it's actually going to be the rally in top lane from the side of LGD. Nice BKB. First one of the game being popped off from Tongfu.
They're trying to chase this one out. It's a nice BKB. Faith, no four step. Probably going to go down here. MMY might as well. He's got Finger of Death, Mystic Flare drop, but it's a rather futile effort as MMY will be picked off in the cogs. They get the two supports, but who cares really? Siler's busy taking buildings. He's going to finish off this tower mid. Hard up. And bottom lane, Yao's also pushing in. They'll TP in one. The Doom does get his ultimate off, but Siler's got 2700 health. Like, what's the follow-up to this? Run after him? He's still very fast. Doom does not remove your move speed.
What if it did, though? What if Doom countered even your ability to walk? What happens then?
Siler literally took no damage from that blaze. Like, he's still at 90% health.
And Heart of Rest fills him up to full. It's just like, in this position, they literally need to be able to converge 5 versus 1 against Siler. They need to Doom hook him and have no response from LGD in order for that to work. It's desperation mode. I mean, is there a point where you call GG before a tier 3 drops?
No, I mean, I think you've invested this long.
Yeah.
It's kind of silly to GG out now. But if they lose a fight, a convincing vitality, then maybe they consider it.
Sure. Where do they even take the fight?
I don't know. That's a good question. Wherever they can find one, man. But I'm not sure where that's going to be. Like, they really need, I don't know, just more initiation. Clockwork Hook... and Doom with a Blink, at this stage of the game, is just not enough. And they even have to Blink on the Witch Doctor, but they need different heroes, I don't know. It's
like, yeah, really.
It's like, man, it'd be great if I had a Faceless Void right now on the side of Tongfu.
I don't know, man. It's just like they've been rotating their defensive abilities. LGD knew they had the late game, so they just rotate between Stampede and Song. As long as one's up, they're fine, unless they get Doomed. And now that's not even a factor. Like, you can Stampede the Doom away, you can just stay high HP with the Heart. They do get a deny, but they've already accrued so much gold on LGD's side. Like, before, they already had the tower disadvantage, and then they had a 4,000 gold lead. Generally speaking, when you're down two towers, you're not going to be in that kind of position, but LGD are able to farm up the enemy jungle, farm up their own, and they take the full lead across the board, and even a tower denial gold is just icing on the cake.
In July, 4th step in, I'll stun Red before he can get off the batteries on Orcogs, then he's fingered down. MMY delivers the blast of pure agony, and that's the death once again of the clockwork. Meanwhile, Faith's just lurking. Maybe
he's laying a trap right now. He's like, oh, come on, deward me. But
oh, they're going. They're waiting for this blink hex. And Kabu blinks out a little bit quicker. Did get the D ward. Though hope he counter D warded. Ward wars.
Splendid.
Yeah, I'm feeling like the end is nigh here for Tong Fu. Just waiting for LGD to take that really convincing fight. Maybe wait for Siler's butterfly and just begin the slow siege. He's very close to it.
Nope. In July, fighting some neutrals up. Gonna go toe-to-toe with the Hellbears, bring his HP kind of low, but beyond that, he's just gonna run around with Tranquil Boots. Actually, his Aegis is gonna expire soon enough. He'll just treat that as a regen rune 1 minute from now.
Yeah, who needs to go heal? The only thing I could fault Siler for is he accidentally blocked the Radiant camp here, which at this point is basically his camp, so that's my biggest criticism of Siler this game. He's denied himself a precious 80 gold, maybe 100 even. But other than that, yeah, just waiting for this aggression to come out. Siler's not picked up his Defusal Blade too. Not going for the Butterfly, so it seems like they'll just look to win a convincing fight, and Defusal is going to be very nice against some of these heroes. The Viper, the Bristleback especially.
Yeah. There are only two heroes up top for LGD. They do have the Stampede, but they don't have BOTs on the Naga to try to song them out. So if they did get a hook, I think that would be at least one kill in their favor. But I don't know if 30 kills would help Tong Fu right now. If they don't prevent Siler from doing his thing, if they don't kill him off twice, then there isn't much they can do. With these last wards snuffing out across the map, they're losing any hope of really getting what they need out of this game. We do see big damage coming out on Xiaolove. He is facing them. And the Mystic Flare, the Finger of Death, the combo is plenty against those tanky.
But a great hook from Red. We'll find both supports. Force Staff out. Number one on Faith. Now the Song, counter initiation, but still MOS trapped. He's taking out of the battery salt. Battery salt? Oh, too late. He's down. But Siler will now retreat. Can they chase him a little bit further is the question. No, nothing to go in. So they get a nice kill there in the line, but it doesn't amount to more. Even if they kill two supports, it's still like, it's gotta be someone more important. I honestly, it just has to be Siler. Like, even killing the Centaur of the Brew is still not that big of a deal. Like, what are you going to do after that? You're still going to see all your lanes pushed in. You're still not getting anywhere near the river. Yeah, I don't know. In July for now, he's going to keep this bottom lane pushed in. He's just waiting for an opportunity to jump in on U9. The Viper sitting back, clearing out the wave, and Tong Fu boxed in pretty much completely. Now they'll jump in. There's your stomp to start on U9. The follow-up will be there from Siler. BKB tries to run, but gets netted. Held in position. More illusion streaming out. He doesn't have a song ready, though. 3 seconds to go. We'll have it soon. And the illusion army begins to do its work on the high ground. Not sure it's enough for a kill. As Kabu... Oh, he's way too far. Now, Kabu! He thought they had run away, but they're here to stay.
So, I just added something to my mechanical checklist I'll check out a little bit later today, but I'm wondering if Song of the Siren against Clockwork makes it so the cogs are invulnerable or not, because MOY wasn't trying to beat his way out of the cogs, so curious if that was or was not an option for him.
I'm not actually sure. That's a good one to research, though. Definitely a fairly obscure mechanic, but
that's
what
I'm all about,
man.
I don't know it, I want to know it, so I have a big like log of different things that I can look up in the near future.
No, I don't mean obscure in a bad way. It's an important one, you know? In that case, if he couldn't beat his way out of the cogs, then, yeah. Even if he had, it would have taken a few auto attacks. He might have died anyway to battery salt, but would have been close. And regardless, LGD's still in good position here. Top lane at the base, mid lane at the base. Bottom lane has pushed out ever so slightly. It'll make it, like, right here. Not even quite.
So they get the Yule Scepter on MMY, an extra disable against Kabu, and now they're get out of jail free card if they get caught out as they were last time by the Clockwork. It's just they have so many ways to respond to things that Tong Fu can bring, and it's going to take the Super Doom to really make things happen. Like, they need to get a Doom and a Naga Siren who's under tier 4s or something if they're going to be able to pull their way back in. We do see this
in my July. Now the follow-up with the Doom, and now the Witch Doctor all comes out doing good damage to Faith. Now focus on Injuli. It's a full duration. Look at it go! And Injuli probably goes down here to the Doom damage denied by Siler. Oh, that's frustrating. They at least finally kill off somebody important. But even then, it's only denied. Blinking forward. They'll get a cask off on Siler. Bounces back to the illusion. The hookshot misses. Oh, they needed that to hit.
They did, and that would have actually been a kill on the Naga Siren there. Siler might have been able to Manta out in 5 seconds, but that wasn't the all. Everything that he needed to get out of that was on cooldown. If he had gotten the hook, I actually think they would have gotten Siler for the first time in a long time.
Siler now sitting on 3,800 gold, so had the buyback there, and I guess we'll see the butterfly coming next for him. But he's getting to the point where it's not about the 6 slot of Naga, it's about the 8-10 slot of Naga. What will Siler start adding to his inventory next? Do Tongfu allow him to sit back and farm? They seem like they want to take a Roche, but Song will be up for this. And Centaur respawning 22. No buyback for him, though. A walk into the pit. Does Siler contest? He's moving into position. Send illusions to scout, but this Roche is going to drop pretty quickly with Goose stacking up. So if he wants to go in, it's got to be real soon. MMY now making his move towards the pit. They're all converging. BKB's coming out. They're trying to finish off the Roshan. They get the Aegis on the Bristle. Then the hook in. We'll finish off the Lion. But they manage to get off the Bruce Split. It's up to Xiaolu to kill these off. And he'll look to do so, even with the Mjolnir. It's just a little bit too much damage. Witch Doctor ult being channeled just for a few seconds, but not enough. And oh, by the way, Siler's still here. He's still at full health as well. Hosong. They'll wait for everything to cool down. They'll let like, Ijlai get in the position. Then the two-hero stomp follows up. The clap's there as well. They'll lose the Aegis. Tongfu. It was almost a gambit trying to go for this. Xiaolu will come back to life and go down again.
Sky hit the Viper and dropped onto 5 HP from Corrosive Skin. Faith almost just killed himself, but with a concussive shot, no less.
He
but
was totally unneeded there, too. They were not getting out of the pit at
that point. The Viper's running fast. You know it. I don't know. This is...
Please.
I'm looking for something. A hope of a random kill on a random support hero.
Well, here's a kill on a support hero, but it's the wrong team. Siler just munches down on Kabu's Witch Doctor. And LGD will take this one now. They'll get at least 2 lanes of racks off of this. If they had buybacks, well, actually they even do. They have a buyback on the Bristle. Not sure why he's reserving it. He'll use it now, but this top lane of racks dead for sure. Blinking for the Doom. Doom is ready, but Jinjai's going to counter this. He just runs right back in with the stomp, gets the kill. Siler's still at full health. He's not even going to really drop for this. It's up to Xiaolu to find his out. Well, it doesn't matter. They'll GG. They had their shots early, but the really inefficient Doom play early on and just lack of anything else getting accomplished kind of sealed their fate.
There you go. LGD Dota. Siler Dota. Burning out that 19-minute Radiance and just farming up the storm. Massive GPM, massive control over the map, and Tongfu just didn't have what it took to take it down. I think the draft could have worked for them, but they needed a lot more in the early game, and they unfortunately just did not find it. So 709 GPM on the Naga, 507 CS. That's what we expect from Siler Dota.
Well, guys, with that being said, that's going to wrap up our coverage of the China region for today for Star Ladder Season number 10 with this LGD. We'll improve the record a bit here, and you can check the results real quickly. Lie Gaming, HGT, that's probably the big surprise, I guess, to the casual fans, as they took down IG, but they're now 4-0 Blaze in Star Ladder China. And even looking at the grid, which hasn't been updated yet, but yeah, HGT 4-0. Newbie, not looking quite so hot after their loss to Vici. I mean, they're 3-1. Vici, now tied with them, 3-1 as well. And IG knocked down a peg to 2-2, while Lie Gaming rises to 2-2. LGD joins them. They're still pretty close race overall. Top 4 teams move to the playoffs, and then, well, at the end of it all, the top two go to the LAN Finals in Kiev. So guys, hope you enjoyed the coverage. We'll take an hour and 15-minute break. Then we come roaring back for Star Ladder Europe. Stay tuned. Follow Blaze at BlazeCasting, myself at LDDota on Twitter. All VODs at youtube.com/BeyondTheSummitTV. And with that, we'll take a break. We'll be back soon. Stay tuned.